I was doing a burn engraving. This one's saying loose. Give you an idea on what I actually do and why it's not perfect neat like you do see with a lot of these ones in the shops and stuff like that. They do it with a laser burner or a CNC machine with a burner on it. I tend to not own those sort of equipment and I have only got this pyro pen, so I tend to do my work with this. I have no other option, but it also gives a hand drawn sort of look. It's not something that I profess to be good at, not that I profess to be good at a lot of things, but it takes time. It doesn't always work the way you want it to, but what I do is I do a drawing of what I think the people might want, like that, and then old school fashion, colour it in on the back, or use graphite powder, and then transfer it over onto the work, and then sit here and slowly draw it all back in again. So realistically, you probably sit there and do the same drawing at least four times. One time to draw it, one time to trace it. Four. So yeah, one time to draw it, one time to trace it, one time to go over it just to make sure it's all in there, and then the actual burning. And when it comes to the thicker lines, you sort of have to do double width. You can go like this sometimes, but it's not always as accurate. So the pen's shaped like that, so I can either go like that as a fat line or like that as a skinny line, but I tend to just do the lining and then go back and fill it in where I want it to be filled in. Similar to drawing, really. Now, this is a camp for wood, and I'd have to say that the burning of the camphor wood doesn't smell as good as what the wood does itself. Jarrah, on the other hand, when you burn it with one of these wands, it smells really nice. When you burn it in the fire, it doesn't smell that crash hot. Some woods don't smell nice burning this way, or actually doing the burning of these lines here gives a different smell again. I have no idea why. That's a friction burn. This is a scalding electronic burn, I guess. It's not actually putting electricity into the wood, it's just heating this little piece of wire up, so I don't see why it'd be that much different, but it is. And burning in a fire is doing the old chemical reaction of fire, and that I guess gives a different smell again. I have no idea why, but it does. You can see why I don't tend to promote doing this, because it takes quite some time to do, and come up with the idea of the writing and all that sort of stuff, and then That's not what I tend to do. If I get a better view of that if I come around there, please. You might see a bit better what I'm doing. I just don't want my hand in the way of it all. That's what I'm trying to do. I've got this turned not all the way up. It's probably 3/4 of the way up. I have it too hot like I do when I have Jarrah, you got to have this thing almost glowing to get a decent burn, but this camphor tends to absorb this quite nicely, or burn quite nicely, do a nice line quite easily with a bit lower heat. Don't want to do it too harshly, but if you stab straight through it or burn a big mark on it where you don't want it to be. See, now if I go around this corner and come up more flat with the pen, you can do a thicker line. And a lot of you probably seen me doing this on the bottom of the cups. I'm not as particular when it comes to that on the bottom, as long as you can read it, it's not a problem. Whereas this here is a feature of the cup, really. Of course, while I'm doing this, the grain of the wood always wants to take the pen in its direction. So the gotta sit there and make sure it burns through and goes the direction that you want it to go. One letter. And there we go. Lewis. Hope that was exciting.